Beyond, and hello everyone, Jonathon Dornbush here with some exciting PlayStation news to discuss. Joining me is Brian Altano.
Beyond,
Brian, good to be here with you, because of course we're talking about the latest PlayStation acquisition, Bluepoint Games. Very, very exciting. They are now the 16th PlayStation Studios sort of first-party studio in the family. They most recently, of course, made Demon's Souls, the PS5 launch title, and one of the first PS5 exclusives around. The Shadow of the Colossus remake on PS4, the Uncharted Nathan Drake collection on PS4, Gravity Rush Remastered. They've sort of been in a whole remaster remake space with PlayStation for a while, and now they've finally decided to, I guess, developer marry? I don't really know what the technical term is for this.
Yeah, this is we've seen a couple of studios sort of adjacent to PlayStation make it official, basically, right? We've seen it with Insomniac. We saw it with Housemark just recently. These are studios that have long-running relationships with PlayStation, making exclusive games or just making games in general. And now they're getting the support of Sony themselves officially. And that's, I think, very exciting. It's very exciting for people who like these games. It's very exciting for people who want to see these studios thrive. And also because, this doesn't feel like a scenario where these studios are taking away from the competition, because they weren't really making a bunch of multi-platform games to begin with. So if you're a big Xbox fan, like, this isn't a gigantic loss for you either, right?
No, yeah, they've really not been involved in the non-PlayStation space for a while. They worked on the Xbox 360 version of Titanfall, but since then kind of have been very, very PlayStation focused. And so, yeah, as you said, this is not like a, oh no, Nintendo and Xbox will not be getting all the games they were going to be getting. This is sort of a, this has been an obvious close relationship for a long time. And as you pointed out, it gives the studio stability and certainty in a way that they didn't have before. And that's actually one of the many things I spoke to Marco Thrush, the president of Bluepoint, and Hermen Hulst, the head of PlayStation Studios. There's a fuller interview up on IGN right now with more that you can go check out. But a few things that they talked about that I want to touch on and discuss with you, as I know you're a huge fan of Bluepoint's work, obviously Demon's Souls, and just excited for the future for them. The first thing, I think the most important thing, is that they are not doing another remake next. They are going to be working on original content, Marco said. They want to sort of focus on making their own creative vision come to light. And Marco described a little bit of how, there's been this progression of the studio of working on some of their earliest games are really smaller games. They worked on ports or remasters, then went on to fuller remakes. And they are a studio, the founders are formerly Retro Studios, the Metroid Prime developers. There's a whole bunch of, long story talent at Bluepoint who've worked on original games in the past. And I think there's probably like a thirst there to want to work on something original themselves. I'm sure they've had a lot of ideas percolating while recreating these other games. So what does that mean to you as them approaching the original space versus, another remake?
It's incredibly exciting, honestly, and really fascinating to me, because I think that this breaks them immediately. And obviously, we haven't played their new game yet. We don't even know what it is. But this does sort of get them away from the pigeonholing that I believe a lot of, fans, like myself, probably assumed that they would be in forever, right? It seemed like a safe, good spot for them to continue to remaster or remake classic games that were, a little bit old, not necessarily like, stuff from the 8-bit era or anything like that, but stuff that, is a couple of generations old, needed a fresh coat of paint. But I'm really excited to see what they can do that's brand new, because they've been mucking around in the back end of some of like the greatest games ever made. They've probably learned a trick or two. And that's pretty interesting, because I have a feeling there's going to be a lot of naysayers that might read the headline around this story and this acquisition and just go, oh, they're a port house, they're a remaster studio, remake studio, whatever. I can kind of brush them aside. But knowing that they are this talented and this sort of technically proficient, especially when it comes to graphics and just sort of like their rock solid approach to the technical foundation of building video games, and applying that skills and that history to something new is really, really cool.
Yeah, it's a really exciting potential. And I think anyone who, I think we've even talked about it on the show, is the minute Bluepoint announced Demon's Souls officially, it was kind of like, oh my God, that's so awesome. But what's their next remake going to be? What should the next five PlayStation remakes that they handle be? And it, as you just said perfectly, like, it's easy to pigeonhole them in that way, but there's so much talent there. There's obviously creative ambition there. And so to see what they'll do originally is really exciting. And I think it speaks to a little bit of the trust between them and PlayStation, because Demon's Souls and Shadow of the Colossus, you know, originally were not the biggest selling PlayStation games ever, but they were two really critically beloved games that PlayStation said, okay, we trust this third party studio to take our internal assets that we still have, to take the bones of these games, to work with our developers and learn from what they did and then put their own mark on it, but stay true to that vision. That shows a lot of trust already. So I think bringing them in only more, to me, shows a sign of confidence that, like, whatever Bluepoint wants to do next must really be exciting to PlayStation.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. I mean, I think that probably connected the dots with both of those things, right? Like, I think they probably said, I'm not sure how this pitch came together to be acquired, but I have a feeling there, Sony was sort of like, so what do you want to work on? You know, and they said, we want to make something new. And they said, great, come on over. Officially, I mean, you're already here, but
yeah,
put a ring on it or whatever.
You're kind of hanging out in the lobby most of the time. But so, yeah, just like, we have a space for you. Just come upstairs.
Yep.
But yeah, it is one of those things Marco talks about a little bit of, like, you know, obviously working in partnership with PlayStation, they had opportunities like having a full London orchestra do the score for Demon's Souls, or they had opportunities to work with the tech pipelines of the other PlayStation studios. Now that stuff is just like, there's no sort of red tape that they have to go through. They're just part of that ecosystem. If they want to rely on the amazing motion capture that, you know, PlayStation Studios has, it's very easy to get in contact for that stuff. If they have other ideas, if they need support, things of that nature, it seems like just a better, more stable environment for them to create whatever they want to going forward.
Yeah, they could have like a dedicated London orchestra conference room with they're just hanging out. They're just there all the time. No, joking
aside. That would be expensive.
A small orchestra,
yeah.
A quartet maybe. I think that this is something that's really cool. And like you said, getting that level of resources and that level of trust is core to the foundation of a big studio like this. It means that their next game is not something they have to sort of look over their shoulder about and be like, does this need to be financially successful? Is it okay if this gets delayed? Like, is this going to make or break us? You know, every studio or many studios sort of live and die based on their last hit or their last failure. And I think that this is really like solid for them and very sort of positive and empowering to see that they'll be able to grow for years to come. Because this is not something that Sony's just going to abandon after, you know, pulling in to the forefront here. I think what is sort of interesting to me is that it does. I mean, I still want remasters of classic games. So yeah. I'm hoping that they can staff up and they can do that too, because they're really, really good at that. And obviously, like, there was a lot of rumors over the last year, Metal Gear Solid 2, Silent Hill, you know, stuff that is like sort of PlayStation adjacent or PlayStation parallel, but not owned by PlayStation. There were a lot of stuff that we thought Bluepoint could be working on. There was that, you know, that infamous tweet, not infamous, I'm sure infamous was in the tweet, but there was a tweet that listed like a bunch of different video game titles before Demon's Souls was officially announced from Bluepoint. And so who knows what the future holds? I would like to see them eventually do both, but for now, I'm very happy to see them do something brand new.
Yeah, it is an element of the last few years of PlayStation releases that I, now seeing that they're going to be doing original content, I almost feel like I've taken for granted of like, but no, I still want a home for those remakes too. And even if it's not Bluepoint, I hope that, you know, now that they're officially part of PlayStation, they can pass along that knowledge to another studio, whether internally or a third party partner, you know, rather than PlayStation having to say, okay, we'll hire this studio that we like third party wise to do remakes. But then we also have to make sure Bluepoint is okay with us, like working with us through them. Now they're just part of it and they could pass along that knowledge in a cool way. So I'm hopeful for that. They did, Marco and I talked a little bit, obviously their next project is a bit of a ways off, but they've had a surprising sort of release cadence. They've gone through things quite quickly, not really more than 3 years. And he said, like, with original content, it is natural for that stuff to just take more time than, you know, a remake of a game. So I wouldn't expect like, we're going to hear what Bluepoint's big game is and see it release next year or something like that, even though that would play into their remake cadence. I wouldn't expect it just yet, but I do think this plays into, as you were saying earlier, the like PlayStation doubling down on the relationships they've had and just making sure that that is a sure thing PlayStation players have to look forward to, which I think is a really cool benefit for the audience.
Yeah, I think maybe in a couple of years or maybe sooner than that, we might see PlayStation make some sort of like, you know, out of left field acquisitions or something like that. I think Xbox has been doing that over the last few years to sort of fortify their identity and sort of, you know, build up their presence in gaming. Sony has that. Obviously, Xbox does too, right? They're doing great right now and have been for 20 years. But Sony has a fantastic stable of studios underneath them and studios that are like all but, you know, first party. So they were always right there. And so it's just like we said with Housemark, like it's awesome to see them sort of, you know, put stock and investment and faith into these studios that they've been trusting for years and to make it official.
Yeah, totally. It's one of those things where, you know, the PS4 and the PS5, I kind of have just thought of Housemark and Bluepoint as part of PlayStation at this point. So this kind of just makes it official. And is a nice little stamp to know that we're going to get the next Bluepoint game. We're going to get the next Housemark game. And they already both know their ways around a PS5. So it's going to be very exciting to see what they do in a few years. But definitely recommend everyone go check out the fuller interview on IGN.com. Spoke with both Hermen and Marco, and a lot of great fun, a little insights into just how that relationship works. And really appreciate you, Brian, taking the time to speak with me.
Yeah, of course. And, you know, for everyone else, we do podcasts beyond all the time. We're always talking about PlayStation on that show. And go check out, I mean, just go watch gameplay footage of Demon's Souls and Shadow of the Colossus, and just to get an idea of what the studio is capable of technically. Because I can't wait to see what they do that's brand new. It's going to be super cool.
Yeah, it's a really exciting time, and there's a lot of potential ahead. And we'll obviously be discussing more of that on Podcast Beyond. So, Brian, thank you so much for joining me, and thank you to everyone out there for watching.
Of course, Beyond.